Yo, what's up?
It's Patrick from Guy in the Cube, and there's so many things happening with Fabric. But one thing we haven't talked about is this new direct link mode for Power BI. It's really phenomenal. And so in this video, I decided to tell you what it is and how you could build out a model that's in the direct link storage mode, all right? So Power BI initially had two primary storage modes, direct query and import. With direct query, what would happen is Power BI would generate a DAX statement. That DAX statement will be converted to the dialect of the source. So let's say the source is SQL Server, it would be converted to T-SQL, and then it would run a query and pull the data back. With import mode, when you schedule a refresh, Power BI would send queries to the source and pull that data into memory. Now, if it's a small amount of data, no worries, no problem, right? And if you have a really good DBA and that source is really optimized, queries probably come back really quickly. But when you start working with large volumes of data, it could slow down. And you have to do things like aggregations and composite models and all types of things to make it work and speed up the refresh. But then Microsoft introduced a third storage mode called Direct Link. And basically what Direct Link does is when the DAX query is generated, Power BI will page the data from the underlying Parquet files into memory as it needs it. If it's queried more, it stays in memory. If it's queried less, Power BI is smart enough, the engine is smart enough to kick it out of memory. That's just the basic description of it, but it does a really good job of it. And so how do I get started with this? How do I make this work? Well, you know how we like to do? Enough of all this talking, let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. You need to have your workspace backed by Fabric capacity. And so we're gonna go to my workspace here and we'll go to premium and you'll see that I back my workspace by Fabric capacity. Now, this is just an F2 and you create a lakehouse or a warehouse. It'll work with either one and you get some data into your lakehouse or warehouse. Now there is a default semantic model that comes with this. I just prefer to create my own model. So you can create your own model when you're in the lakehouse. You'll see new semantic model, you click there and it's gonna allow you to select your tables and then you'll land in your semantic model. I've already created one. I'm gonna go here and I'm gonna go into the model view and you'll see I've created my model and I think I have one measure that I created here, okay? And I can, you know, add calculation groups, add measures, manage relationships, build a report off of it. But the important thing here though, if you hover over it, you'll see that it's in direct link mode. If you click the table and go to the properties of it and go to advanced, you'll see it's in direct link mode and you can't change it to anything else. I'm gonna show you in the subsequent video some things that you can do if you wanted to import, if you wanted to direct query, but if you want to take advantage of the direct link storage mode, don't mess with this. Don't do anything. Just accept how it is. Because the way it works, you're not importing all the data into memory. You're not sending queries out to some huge relational database and trying to bring that back. It's only going to query what it needs, pull it into memory really quickly. It'll do a little transcoding, but all of the compression, all of the encoding that needs to happen, it happens on that Parquet file that are created in the lakehouse or the warehouse. So it's directly querying the lake. Directly, hence directly. So I've created this notebook because I want to show you how this works. So I'm going to go here to my notebook. You can see I have my lake house and I have all the tables. So I'm going to run some queries against this. So let's see how many rows are in this table. Here we go. Let's run this. So this is in my lake house. I've created my semantic model. I'm querying the lake house directly. So here we go. It's going to tell us how many rows are in each year. We can see that in the underlying cab rides table, that's part of my semantic model, we have 131 million rows, okay, only for 2016. Now, remember I said that the direct link mode, it moves things in and out of memory as needed. And so what you can do in a notebook is you can use this library called SymPy to actually run DMVs and refresh data sets and stuff like that. But the very first thing I'm gonna run, I have to import my libraries. Here we go. We'll run this and let's see if there's anything in memory. If there is something in memory, that means I ran some queries. But you can see, if we scroll down right here, the dictionary temperature is resident in memory. The dictionary size, last accessed, each one of the columns in the tables completely empty. Nothing's actually going to move into memory until I issue a query against the semantic model. That query can come from the visuals on the report. It could just come from like Management Studio or DAX Studio or directly here in the notebook. Let me clear this out just so I can have a little space. And so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna run a query and I'm just gonna run it against calendar year. So I'm gonna run this, boom. Right now I'm going to go back and I'm going to run this query. Let's see what's in, if anything has been moved into memory. And just like that, you can see stuff has been moved into memory. Now let's go and add some more data to this table. And so as you query stuff, it'll move in and out of memory. But what happens when I update the underlying source? Does it automatically pick it up? So I'm going to run this So I inserted some new data. We're actually going to go all the way back to the top just to validate that the data has been pulled into the lake house. And so we can absolutely see that the data is there. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to run a query that's going to give me the average trip price and the total number of rows in the database in my semantic model, right? That's going to directly query that. So we'll run that. Let's see. The data's there. How did it get there? I didn't refresh it. I didn't do anything to it. It's a concept called reframing. When you do a refresh of the model, it tells Power BI, hey, this is the files you should read. But when you create a semantic model in Fabric, there's a property that says automatically sync everything. Let me show you. So I'll go here to the workspace and I'll go to the settings of the semantic model. And then under refresh, you'll see that it automatically detects the changes in the OneLake. That's going to automatically sync any changes you make, schema changes, table changes, adding more data. Do you really want that to happen in an enterprise type solution that you're creating? Probably not. So you want to turn that off and then you can make this part of your nightly refresh. You can reframe the data set or refresh the data set, and it should happen pretty quickly. So I'm going to turn this off. I'm going to click apply, and then I'm going to go back to my notebook. And what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to delete the rows from my managed table in my lake house. So I'm going to run this query. This query should run pretty quick, about 12 seconds. I'm going to run the query actually against that table in the lake house to validate what data is there, right? So 2015 is gone. Now I'm going to run the exact same query that I ran before where there was 2015 and 2016. Remember, 2015 no longer exists in the actual managed table in the lake house, but I turned that setting off so it doesn't automatically sync. So let's see what happens. So we're going to run this. It's still there. And that's because I turned the setting off. And that means as part of your ETL process, you need to schedule a refresh of that semantic model. Or you can do it in a notebook really simply. Once you have SymPy installed, you can run this. Give me the name of the data set, the workspace, and it's gonna refresh every table in the model and do a full refresh. So if I run this, watch how fast it runs, right? Run that really quickly. Now when I run this, right, 2015 is gone. So just some things to know about Direct Lake and how it works. Now, there are some guardrails placed around Direct Lake, and I'll put a link to the document down below. There's this thing called SQL fallback, which will cause your model, instead of reading the Parquet files directly, it's gonna go over and run some direct queries against it, and it could slow down. I'll do a video to talk about fallback and how you can test it and validate whether or not things are happening. All right, what do you think? Are you using Direct Lake? Do you have any challenges? Do you have any questions? Comments, I love to know. You know what to do. Post it in the comments below. If you want to know more about Fabric, guess what? There's probably a video flying above my head. And as always, Matt and myself, thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.